In this video, I'm going to give you the signs that you're in ketosis. Hi, I'm Dr. Zarosky from newvisionexcel.com. As always, if you're new to the channel, it is such a pleasure to have you here. Be sure to subscribe, hit that little bell notification, and join our notification community so that you can excel your health and your life. In this video, we're talking about the signs that you're in ketosis. This is something that a lot of people ask. You know, they're saying, I'm following a ketogenic diet and I'm eating keto foods. How do I know if I'm actually in ketosis? Let's go ahead and jump right in. First of all, you want to make sure that you're on a ketogenic diet for an average of 2 to 3 weeks if you want to go into the state of ketosis. And then the other thing, in order to really accurately measure whether you're in ketosis or not, you can use a precision Xtra meter, which is actually going to measure your blood ketone levels. And once you hit that 0.5 millimole per deciliter and above, then you are in ketosis. Now, optimal levels are 1.5 millimoles per deciliter. Now, the other thing that you can use is urine test strips by Bayer Pharmaceutical. You can use those strips. They are not as specific or as accurate as the precision Xtra meter, but they will give you a good understanding of whether or not you are in ketosis. You know, when you start looking in some of the fine lines of, am I at a 0.5 or a 1.5, you're not going to be able to measure it quite as well. But you know, whether you are absolutely out of ketosis or in, it can help you get that knowledge. And the reason that some people use and prefer the urine test strips is just because they are much cheaper than buying the meter and the test strips that go along with it. Let's go ahead and look at some of the signs and symptoms that you are in ketosis. First of all, you're going to have decreased hunger once you're in that ketogenic state. So what that means is you're not going to get headaches or hangry or anxious or have a decrease in focus because you are not having your meal on time. You can actually even cruise right through that meal time without a meal and still not get super hungry. So that's one of the great benefits of ketosis, and you're not going to have those mid-afternoon crashes because you're not burning sugar for energy. You're burning fat for energy, and it's a more sustainable, more stable source of energy for the body. So you're not going to get that hunger all the time. Now, the other thing is that you're not going to have those sugar and carb cravings. You're gonna see a huge decrease in that. Once again, when your body is burning sugar for energy, what happens is every time your blood sugar gets low, your body starts craving sugar and carbs simply because it's trying to boost that back up to give you energy. So when you're ketosis, you're not having those cravings. You're gonna have an increased focus throughout the whole entire day. So you're gonna notice just, you know, overall your focus is so much more increased, but you're not gonna have the focus crashes more or less mid-afternoon or after a meal. You're gonna be able to just maintain that focus. And that's one of the really great things that a lot of people love about ketosis. Now, here's the other thing, is you're gonna have increase in energy. You know, I was talking about the blood sugar. Once again, you know, when you're having blood sugar instability and highs and lows throughout the day, your energy will vary with that. When you're burning fat for energy, it's just that nice sustainable energy all day long, and it gives you that high energy state from morning till night. The next is you're gonna have an increase in fat loss. You might notice your pants are a little bit loose. You might notice that you're you know, shedding that fat around the waistline. So you're going to, though you'll maintain muscle mass, you're going to start shedding that fat, and you'll see some benefits there. You'll also have a decrease in inflammation. One of the ways that you'll know that you'll have a decrease in inflammation in the entire body is that your joints won't ache as much. You'll wake up in the morning not feeling as achy and all those little pains that you normally feel. So you're gonna just feel a lot better overall. So these are the signs that you're in ketosis. If you wanna learn more about ketosis and some of the top foods that you should eat on ketosis, check out a video that I did on that. Other than that, guys, be sure to like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions about ketosis or getting into the ketogenic state, post it in the comments section below. Subscribe to my channel right here, and then check out the other videos that I did on fasting and ketosis. I know you're gonna love them, and then I'll see you in the next video.